Hi everyone, I'm Cody, W3AMG with Bridgecom Systems, and today I will be showing you how to add an analog repeater to your Anytone radio. Let's go ahead and get started. First thing you'll want to do is plug in your radio to your computer and read from your radio. Now in this case, I've already done that, so we're going to skip over this step. But we will plug it in so we can write the information. Awesome, here we go. So I've already read from my radio. First, we actually need to find the repeater we're looking for. So we're gonna open up a web browser and go to repeaterbook.com. Now, if you already have the information written down, then great, you can skip over this step. In this case, we actually are going to go out and find one. So select your area. Okay, awesome. I'm gonna select my state. And here it gives you some options to filter with. In this case, we're not looking for anything in particular, so I'm just going to select all. And at this point, if you would like to have a better search criteria, just go ahead and click on map results and whatever option is available there. And from here, we can actually look at an entire map of our area with repeaters. We'll scroll in here to our location and see if we can't find one that we can connect to. Okay, so we're up here in Smithville. We might be able to hit that one over in Kearney. So let's go ahead and click on that. And we'll click on that for some more information. Here we go. Looks like this is a UHF and it appears to be an analog repeater. Awesome, here we go. So let's go ahead and write this information down. Once again, uplink and downlink as we've discussed before. Uplink, I like to think of repeaters as being up high and radios being down low because that's typically how they are. So uplink in the eyes of the radio is gonna be transmit and downlink in the eyes of the radio will be receive. That'll help you remember that. And now we're not gonna have color codes or time slots with analog. Instead, you'll have PL tones. In this case, we have an uplink tone. So that's gonna go with the uplink, or in this case, transmit frequency. Now there may be a downlink tone, there may not be any tones, or those two tones may be different. So just keep that in mind, make sure you pay attention to them. So we'll write that information down, and we'll go over here and start adding it in. So we need to find a blank space in our code plug. So we're gonna scroll down here until we find one. There we go. There's the DMR repeater we just added. So let's add one below it. And this is going to be the analog repeater. Awesome. So there's our receive frequency. So we'll put that in there, the downlink. And let's go back over and grab the transmit frequency or the uplink. Come back over here. We'll add that in, awesome. Now this is gonna be analog, so we'll change the channel type over to analog. And I'm gonna change the power up to turbo. There we go, and then you'll want to change the bandwidth, in this case, to 25, since we're on analog here. You do wanna add your tones. In this case, since we have a tone, encode is going to be for the transmit and decode is for the receive. Now in this case, over here, we can see it wanted it on the transmit side, the uplink side. So we're going to encode. And let's see what that tone was. 127.3. So we'll put a CTCSS tone on there for 127.3. There we have it. Awesome. Now go ahead and click OK. We're almost done. We do have to add this to a zone. So go over to your zones. There's our local repeater zone we just created. And we'll scroll all the way down here. There's our analog repeater, move that over. And at that point, you are all set. So we'll click OK. Now from here, all we need to do is just write this to our radio and check it out. Awesome, here we go. So on the radio, we have our normal code plug, but let's check it out. So if we go up, there we go, DMR repeater. And what if I rotate this? There's our analog repeater. So we have both of our repeaters now programmed in the radio. How cool is that?